You're listening to the Dibbly Dobbly Podcast. Remember to like, share, comment, subscribe, and click the bell to make sure you get the latest episodes of the podcast. Be sure to like and share our Facebook page and follow us on Twitter. So moving on to the next topic, Scholes, we're going to be talking about preparation. Preparation is very important in the game of cricket. With the season not starting too far away, Scholes, in Australia, players will be thinking about preparing for the season ahead. And Scholes, preparation is very important in what we do in everyday life. We've got to prepare for everything. So, Scholes, why is it important for a player to prepare? And what are the implications for a player who hasn't done the preparation?
Well, look, I think it comes back to how you feel. Like, if you've cheated and taken shortcuts, you're gonna understand that. You're gonna know that you're gonna have that level of anxiety because you're not ready. So I think that there's nothing better than just standing at the top of your mark or over your bat, knowing you've done whatever you can to be successful on that day. So I think it just creates a belief and a confidence in yourself that you've done it. And if you haven't done that, you can't lie to yourself. You know you haven't done it. So yeah, you might get away with it for a little while. You might be able to just fluke it or wing it, but ultimately you haven't put in the work, so you're not going to get the results.
Absolutely. So we go into training. Training's very important for players, obviously. It's where you work on your skills as a player to improve and get better. Often, Scholes, players go to a training session not using their time wisely, without any structure or anything to their session. So, Scholes, what advice would you give to any player on how to go about planning a training session to get the most out of it?
I think you've got to understand what you're trying to improve and work on. What are the things in your game, maybe technically, tactically, mentally, what are the things you need to work on to improve your strengths, but also develop your weaknesses as well? So, and then on the back of that, you can formulate a plan. You can say, right, I need to improve my cover drive. I need to practice getting the size of my step a bit smaller, a bit bigger, or my shoulder getting more side on. So then you can say, right, I'm going to do underarms for 20 minutes to work on that. And then I'm going to focus on just getting in the contest and facing the bowler and winning the contest. So I think, yeah, that like you've got to understand what you're trying to achieve and then work backwards from there and then create a plan based around what you need at the time.
Absolutely. So then we come to game day, Scholes, and all the preparation you've done and the training leading up to game day, to the match itself. It's important that you have to back yourself and trust your preparation and your training that you've done leading up to game day. So, Scholes, how important is that trust in your preparation when it comes to game day to get success and good performance?
You can't. Well, if you doubt yourself or you focus on the doubts, as I said, the doubts will always be there, but if you focus on them, you're not going to perform at your best. That's just a distraction. So for me, I love the saying, train it, then trust it. So you just got to put in the work, and then on game day, you got to trust whatever level you're at. You got to trust whatever your technique is, whatever you've got. You got to try and trust it in that moment because that's all you've got. And if it might not be good enough, but if you're doubting it, it's definitely not going to be good enough. But if you're trusting it, you're giving yourself a chance. So yeah, train it and then trust it. Something I say to all of our athletes.
Absolutely. So then we come to post-game. Now, Scholes, what you do post-game is very important for preparation heading into the next game, the next week. It's a good opportunity to reflect on the match, on what you did well and what you didn't do so well, by doing a self-assessment or self-reflection. Also asking for feedback from coaches and teammates on your performance to get better. So, Scholes, how important is self-reflection or self-assessment and seeking feedback after a game for players?
Oh, look, it's as I said in the 4 hours, like reflection is how you learn. We've got what we call an athlete development journal on the inside of the front cover. It says experience plus reflection equals learning. And I think that you can reflect on training sessions and you can reflect on games and you can learn so much from those experiences and those moments. And that's how you can then, yeah, develop your skill set, your mindset, your understanding of the game to become a better player. So I think so many players neglect this part of their development and then they don't learn as quickly and as much as they could, and they then don't perform as well as they could. So I think it's just vital, vital for players to become the best they can be if they have big ambition in the game.
Absolutely. So it's very important to prepare. You can't skip on preparation. It's like the mental side. You can't skip it because you won't be successful, have good performance leading into the game. So preparation is a very important factor in the game. You can't ignore preparation. If you want to be the best you can be, you have to prepare and put in the hard work to achieve success. Make sure to check out Cricket Mentoring on their website and on their social media platforms. If you want some help to improve your game, then Tom's the right man to help you. Be sure to subscribe and click the bell to get the latest episodes of the podcast, and like and share our Facebook page, and follow us on Twitter and on Instagram. Until next time, keep safe and bye for now.